Good morning, my dear students. Today, let's start the fifth chapter of mathematics, that is fractions. Fractions, you very well know, is what? It is something which has a numerator and a denominator, and it is always written in the form of a upon b, which is sometimes also read as, if suppose I have a fraction 4 upon 7, this can also be read as 4 by 7. This means what? 4 upon 7 means what? That it means that out of 7 equal parts, something is there, it has 7 equal parts which is written in the denominator, and out of those 7 parts, 4 are colored. So the fraction formed will be 4 upon 7. It is also read as 4 by 7. Now in this chapter, you will also see, you will also come to know about the fractional number. What is this term, fractional number? As you can see here, 4 upon 7 is a fraction and 4 sevenths is a fractional number. So in case they are asking for the fractional number, then you have to represent the fraction in this term, in this manner. As you can see here, 1 upon 2, we know 1 upon 2 is also known as half or 1 half. 1 upon 4 can also be written as what? 1 quarter. 2 upon 3 can be read as 2 thirds, 3 upon 5 as 3 fifths, and 5 upon 8 as 5 eighths. So what are these? These are the fractional number. If a figure is given, how you will form a fraction from that figure? Suppose this is the figure, okay, and it has 4 equal parts, and if I color any 2 or any 3 parts and I ask you to write the fraction of this figure. So the fraction for this figure will be what? First of all, in the how we write the fraction? By writing the numerator on the top and denominator down. So denominator has what number? Whatever are the number of parts, whatever are the total number of parts will come in the denominator. Suppose let's count here 1 2 3 4. So 4 are the total number of parts, and how many are colored? 1, 2, 3. So the colored parts will come here. So the answer is what? The answer is 3 upon 4. It can be also read as 3 by 4. Okay. And it can also be read as 3 fourths. 3 fourths. So this is what? This is the fractional name of this fraction. Now, how to represent a fraction on a number line? Suppose I have a fraction and the fraction is 3 upon 7. Now, I have to represent this fraction on the number line. So, what I'll do, I'll draw a straight line first using a what? Scale. And I'll mark 2 points on the scale. Now, the points can be A and B, P and Q. It can be anything. So, if I'm taking A and B, what I'll do first, I'll, you know what is the denominator? Denominator has the total number of parts of that figure. So, what we will do on this line, first we will see the denominator. How many parts the line should have? So, it should have how many parts? 7 parts. So, we will divide this line into 7 equal parts. Suppose 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6, 7. Now 7 parts I have divided this, okay, and what's the fraction? 3 upon 7. So I'll count 1 2 3. So here will be my fraction. Is it clear? Now there's one more topic in this chapter, that is representation of a fraction on a number line. Suppose I have a fraction 5 upon 8 and I have to show it on a on the number line. So what I'll do, I'll draw a straight line using the scale. Using a scale, I'll draw a straight line and I'll mark 2 points of my choice. It can be A, B, B, C or anything. Now what I have to do, I have to mark this fraction on this number line. So how many total parts it has? It has 8 parts. So I will divide this A into B, this entire portion, into 8 equal parts. Okay, so how many lines I have to draw? I will draw 7 lines. If I draw 7 lines, then the parts will be how many? 8. Let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6,
7. I have drawn 7 line and I'll show you how it has 8 parts. First, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Can you see it has 8 parts now? And what I have to show? 5 upon 8. I have to represent this 5 upon 8. So now I'll start counting. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So 5 is coming here. So I'll mark this point. This point will be marked as 5 upon 8. Is it clear? Now let me have one more fraction for you. Suppose the fraction is 7 upon 9. Okay. So I'll draw a straight line. Again, 2 points I'll mark. And now the points can be any. So I'll do what? I'll divide this portion into 9 parts. For the making into 9 parts, I have to make how many lines? 8 lines. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So now you can, let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. We have divided this portion into 9 equal parts now. And I have to represent how much? How many? What? 7 number. So I'll start counting from here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So it will come here, the 7 upon 9. Okay. Or you can do what? You can count the space. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 7 is coming here. So we'll take this as 7 upon 9. Now let's begin our exercise, that is exercise 5A. As you can see, many figures are given. We have done this last year also and last to last year also. You see, we have to write the fractions here. So what you will do, you will simply count the total number of parts and total number of colored parts. Okay. For example, if I take this one, we know it has how many parts? 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. It has 10 equal parts. So denominator, what will come? 10 will come in the denominator. So you can see 10 will come in the denominator. This is how we are forming the fraction. Okay, 10. And how many parts are colored? 1, 2, 3. 3 parts are colored. So 3 will come here. So this is the fraction. Now let's see this one. How many, this flower has how many parts? First, let's count the parts. We need to know the total number of parts, because total number of parts, the number, that number comes in the denominator. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So there are how many parts? 8 parts. So the total number will come in the denominator place. And how many are colored? 1, 2, 3. So 3 are colored. So the fraction will be 3 upon 8. Now let's see this question number 2. We have to shade 4 ninth of the given figure. We have to shade 4 upon 9. We have to show this fraction here. And let's count first whether it has 9 parts or not. 3, 6, 9. Yeah, it has 9 parts. You can color any 4 of your choice. You can take 1, 2, 3, 4 or 1, 2, 3, 4. Any 4 parts you can color. In the given figure, if we say that the shaded region is 1 upon 4, then identify the error in it. Now, what's the error we have to find? They are saying that this fraction, this figure is what? The fraction for this figure is 1 upon 4. And they are asking us, identify the error in it. What's the error? Now, if you notice in all these figures, if you have noticed, the parts are always equal. The figure is divided into equal parts every time whenever you are writing the fraction with a figure. Now, what is here? Fraction is 1 upon 4, but the figure is somewhat, it's wrong. Why? Because these two parts are same and these two parts are same, but all four together are not same. So the figure has to be divided into equal parts in order to show 1 upon 4. Suppose this figure was something like this. Okay, then it was correct. But here, what's the problem? Here, these two parts are very small and these two parts are very big. So this is incorrect. The parts have to be equal in order to form the fraction. Now write a fraction for each of the following. Question number 4. Now we have to write a fraction. 3/4, fraction will be 3 upon 4. 2/5, fraction will be 2 upon 5. Three upon four, 2/5, 5th part, 1/8, and 7th part, 8 upon 9. 8, 9. So can you see how easy it is to form the fraction from the fractional name? Let's see on the next page what is there. Write down the numerator and denominator of each of the fractions given below. We have to write the numerator and the denominator. Now let's see here. What is, suppose this is the fraction. Numerator is the top part. Numerator is the top part and denominator is the bottom part. Is it clear, everyone? And this is every time this only. You cannot say that numerator will come down. The down number is numerator and denominator is the top number. No, it's wrong. Numerator is always on the top and denominator is not down. Write down the fraction in which, now they are asking you, they are judging you, they are seeing whether you know how to form the fraction or not. They are saying, let's take any one example. Write down the fraction in which numerator is 8 and denominator is 15. They have given us these term, these numbers, and we have to form a fraction. Question number 6, fourth part. Okay, so numerator will come on the top and denominator will come down. Okay, and it cannot be cancelled further, so the answer will be 8 upon 15. Seventh one, write down the fractional number for each of the following. We have to write the fractional number. We have, that means we have to give the answers this way. Can you see? This way. So I'm sure that you all can give the answer. It is 2/3, 4/9. Question number 7, first part. 2/3, okay. Then if I see, take so this fourth part, 7 upon 10. So it will be written as 7/10. Seventh part will be 3 upon 8. This can be written as 3/8. Is it clear? Same way you will do the other parts as well. Now question number 8. What fraction of an hour is 24 minutes? If you see the examples here, which is given on your previous page, if you see the examples here, they have given us very clearly the solution. What fraction of a day is 8 hours? Okay, they are asking what fraction. You have to form the fraction of 8 hours, keeping in view one day. We know one day has how many hours? 24 hours. Okay, and we know total always comes in the denominator. So total is how much? One day has how many hours? 24 hours. So 24 will come down and 8 will come on the top. What fraction of an hour is 40 minutes? They are asking what will be the fraction of 40 minutes. We know 1 hour is equal to 60 minutes. 60 is the total number. It will come in the denominator. And they are asking the fraction for 40. So 40 will come on the top. So 40 upon 60 is the fraction. Same way, what we will do, what fraction of an hour is 24 minutes? 28. I know 1 hour is equal to 60 minutes. Okay. And we have to form the fraction for 24 minutes. I know 60 will come down because total number value kahan aati hai? Niche aati hai. And 24 will come on the top. So this is the fraction. Now question number 9. How many natural numbers are there from 2 to 10? They are asking us how many natural numbers are there from 2 to 10. So that means we have to take 2 also. So question number 9, if I do it here so that it is clear to you all, question number 9. Okay, how many natural numbers are there from 2 to 10? So let's count 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Let's count these natural numbers. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So what are the total numbers? Total number of natural numbers? Is 9. Okay, and now they're asking what fraction of them are prime numbers. Okay, now we have to make a fraction of prime numbers out of these natural numbers, which are what? 9. Let's circle the prime numbers. 2 is the only even prime number, 3 is the prime number, 5 and 7. 4 is not a prime number because it comes in table of 1, 2, 4. Neither 6, 8, 9, these are not the prime numbers. So how many are the prime numbers? 1, 2, 3, 4. So prime numbers are how many? 4. Now we have to form a fraction for both of them. So okay, how we form a fraction? We always write the total numbers down. Okay, so total number of numbers are how many here? 9. So 9 will come here, and what are the numbers of prime numbers here? 4. So 4 upon 9 is the fraction. So this chapter is becoming very interesting because we have already done a lot of it in class 4th and 5. Now determine, if you see question number 10, now let me explain first verbally, then I'll solve two parts of it, any of the two questions. 2 upon 3 of 15 pence. We have to solve this sum. We know of means what? Multiplication. So what sign will come here? Of multiplication. And cancelling I have already told taught you before also before. So cancelling is very easy, where we read the table of any number and of such a number in which both these numbers are coming. Okay. And then we cancel the numbers. Let's same way, both questions are same. So I'll take two parts and I'll discuss. I'll explain to you. If I take question number 10 ka third part, that is 2 upon 3 of 36 balloons. Let me write, then I'll show you. And question number 11, I'll take again the third part. Why third part? Because it is difficult. Maybe it is difficult. 3 upon 4 of 32 books. Okay, we know of means what in maths? Multiplication, product. So 2 upon 3 will be same. In place of off, we'll write what? Multiplication. And I always tell you, whenever you start the calculation, you have to put equals to sign. 36 will come here. Now let's read the table of 3, because we know this can go in the table of 3. So 3 ones are and 1, 2. Okay, 12 into 2 will be how much? 24. So this is the answer. 3 upon 4 or 3 by 4 or 3 fourths of means what? Multiplication. 32? Yeah. Okay. So now let's read the table of 4. Okay, we very well know 4 ones is 4 and 4 eights is 32. So both these numbers are cancelled. Now it cannot be cancelled here because it has become 1. It has become 1 and it cannot be further cancelled. So 8 into 3 will be how much? 24. Now question number 12. Neelam has 25 pencils. So total number of pencils are how many? Total number of pencils are 25. She gives 4.5 of them to Meena. So Meena got how many? Meena got 4/5 of these total number of pencils. How many pencils does Meena get? First let's answer this. Okay, we know from this statement 4/5 of them. 4/5 of them means what? We have to do the calculation with this 25. Of them means what? Total number. So 4 upon 5 into 25. 5 into 4 is 20. So 20 pencils Meena got. How many pencils are left with Neelam? Neelam had 25 pencils, and out of 25 pencils she has given 20 to Meena. Okay, so how many are left? 5 pencils are left. Now the 13th question is, represent each of the following fractions on a number line. For this you just need to draw a straight line. Okay, and that straight line you will mark 2 points of your choice, A, B, P, Q, anything. And now you will divide this portion into 7 equal parts. Okay, for dividing it, how many lines will I draw? These lines, small lines, 6 lines. 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, I have drawn 6 lines. Let's count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. The 7th part it has. So the fraction is 4 upon 7. So 1, 2, 3, 4. So this point will be marked as 4 upon 7. Let's see this one. It is what? 2 by 5. So I'll mark any point. Let it be B and C. Okay. And I'll divide this B and C portion into 5 equal parts. So let's see. Let's count whether it has divided into 5 parts or not. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yeah, 5 parts it has been divided. Now we have to represent 2 upon 5. So first part, second part. The 2 upon 5. So 2 upon 5 will come on this line, and this is the representation of a fraction on the number line. So do the remaining sums. So what's the homework? You have to do the remaining sums in your maths register. In case you have any doubt, kindly message and ask me.